All right, welcome back to Muscle Car Madness Garage. So today we're going to start prepping the top of the engine to get it removed. I'm thinking while I'm filming this, I'm thinking that within the next 2 days, I'm going to have it out of the, you know, out of the Mach 1. And so part of the reason I filmed this whole thing is because there's no way I'm going to be able to remember where all these hoses and tubes and everything goes. So this gives me a record of where everything is going. And then also, I've seen a couple of videos about the procedures that people would recommend. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to unhook the drive shaft from the differential side and then ease it down. And hopefully, I think it'll just slip out of the transmission. I've already got the fluid out of the transmission, or most of it anyway, so it shouldn't be a problem. And then I'll ease that down without crashing down on me. At that point, I'm going to take the two bolts out of the motor mounts, two bolts out of the support for the transmission, and then take out the loosen the linkage for the shifter. My hope is that that's it. I'm going to take the engine transmission out altogether, take it out, and then of course I'm going to do the last bit of investigation work on that. Whether or not it's a, you know, a true ARCO, which I think it is, but need to make sure. And then that's it. So once that's out, I still haven't figured out where I'm going to take the thing to get rebuilt, but doesn't matter. I'll work that out later. And then start the cleanup on the engine bay, work my way back from bumper to bumper. So now I'm going to film where all the little parts go, and then off the top end, and we'll go from there. So found out these hoses here for a power steering pump, and they go on top of one of them braces. In fact, there's the bolt that, or, you know, the hole that the bolt goes in. So where we're going to start is right here. If you remember, I couldn't figure out what this is. I think it's for the steering box cooler. The fluid goes in the steering box cooler, or the transmission, or power steering here. So it goes down into the steering box, and it comes back up. And so what I'm going to do is unhook, I think it's this one right here. This one right here, because that's the one that goes into the steering box right down there. All right, so I'm going to unhook that one right there. Yeah, and it goes all the way around here to there. And then I'm going to unhook this here, the cooler. There's a couple of wires I'm going to hook. There's some kind of a vacuum, I guess, right there. I think this may be speedometer here, perhaps. Yeah, got to be your tachometer. That's going to be unhooked. This wire here plugs in to some sort of sensor, I guess, or ground or something right there. And I'll tell you this, I saw a video, an old boy was doing this. He says, do yourself a favor, if you got an old car, redo the entire wiring harness. And I thought, my oh my, I mean, that seems so intimidating to me, you know. But he said, look, why fooling around with 40-year-old wires? I thought, hey buddy, how about 50-year-old wires? What do you think about that? I would like to do it, but I swear, you know, I wouldn't know where to begin. And of course, this is solenoid. It is currently not hooked into the engine. Just hanging on right here with electrical tape. Makes me sort of, I don't know, real uneasy. But nevertheless, that's where I'm going to start right now. Get the ball rolling on this thing. Welcome back to Muscle Car Madness Garage, fellas and mama. Welcome. This is the day. This is the day we've been talking about, or I've been talking about for a long time. Let me bring you up to speed about what happened last night, all right? I went ahead and got up on the jack. It's going to rain here in Birmingham last night, so I went ahead and unhooked all of the things that hold this engine in place, at least I think. On the top side, I'd already done that. Went down below and did it on the bottom side. All of the supports on the transmission. I unhooked the drive shaft and also the motor mounts, all unhooked. Well, it was gonna rain, so then I pushed it inside. This is where the Mach's gonna live for a while. And now that I got everything on underneath unhooked. However, when I started moving it, the drive shaft started to fall out. And that was fine, because that was, you know, that's what needed to happen anyway. However, the transmission sunk down, and I had not pulled out the gear shifter. So you can see it's sort of leaning like that, which tells me the transmission is down, which is fine. So my problem is that I should have maybe taken out the shifter first, okay? And as you can see, the engine's leaning down. Now, here's what I'm going to try to do, is that I'm going to hook up the jack, the engine hoist, to that thing right there, and then I'm going to start wrenching on it. Hopefully, my hope is that the transmission sinks down a little further. I'm going to try to get the angle to let it sink down, and then I'm going to move the engine forward, so hopefully the shifter just comes out of that hole. Now, whether or not that's possible, I don't know. The other thought I had was I can take the jack now and lift it up and lift the car up, and at the same time, that might lower the transmission even further, and that way I can just slide the engine out at an angle, so maybe the shifter comes out that hole. Now, I don't know if that's even possible. I really don't know. And if it's not possible, I'm not sure how I'm going to get this shifter off of the transmission. I mean, maybe it's real possible just to unhook it right there, which would make it a whole lot easier. I'm going to explore that just for a few minutes. But nevertheless, the next clip you see, this sucker's coming out of this car. And then we're going to verify once and for all, is this an R code 351 Cleveland? I hope so. Here we go. All right, this is it. I gotta take the exhaust out now. It's gone.